Sue here. I'm gonna start off by showing you my face. This is after it being washed, nothing on it. So you see my redness, my scars, all my blemishes. I'm gonna start off with the, come on, Paula's Choice Azelaic Acid Booster with licorice and salicylic acid. I'm using this due to the acne that I've been having around my chin and my cheek and my brows. So I'm gonna rub it all over. And today's video is going to be about two different foundations that I bought. I was super excited to buy them and been wanting to test them out for a long time. Second, I'm gonna use my Paula Choice Youth Extending Daily Hydrating Fluid SPF 50. I noticed that when I've been aging, I'm not that old, but old enough, I've been getting a lot of sunburn, especially around my lips. My lips is a little red today because yesterday I did a lip tint on it, so left it alone as it is. Next, I'm gonna wear my Urban Decay Primer All Nighter. It's been good to me thus far. I haven't had any issue. I do like it. I'm gonna rub it all over my face again. Look at my cheeks and my nose. Yeesh. Okay, next, I'm gonna take this tape just because I want you guys to see my natural skin color. I'm not sure if the foundation I bought is gonna match. I just did it all purely online with matching my skin and matching my old foundation. So watch me put tape on my face. Okay, so now I'm also gonna put a bigger tape on the side of my face, just because I really want to ensure and make sure that the foundation does work or match my skin. So watch me do that as well on both sides of my face. Alright, so the first foundation I'm gonna try is the Fenty Beauty Pro FILT'R Soft Matte Foundation in the color shade 300. So I'm gonna put that on my left side of my face just to see how it looks like. So my face is looking kind of good. It looks like it's matching my neck. Now I'm gonna try the other foundation, which is Estee Lauder Double Wear in the shade 4W1. Looking at my face, it looks like Estee Lauder is a little bit more dewier than the Rihanna's Beauty Fenty. Up close, you still see my pores. It does still look pretty natural. Estee Lauder looks like it still matches my skin too, but gives me a little bit lighter of a hint. Then I'm going to set my foundation with powder first. Dab, dab, dab with powder. Come in with a powder brush and I'm just gonna brush off all the excess and rub it into my skin so I can get that nice finished look to see how it sets in my face. Alright, so here is the final look for both the foundations. It's looking actually really good doing the voiceover and reviewing myself. So I'm taking off the tape so you can see my natural skin color. And now, when I remove it, you just see that hint of orange. I feel like I look really orange. And now I'm removing it on the left side with the Fenty Beauty, and you can really see the color change on me. It's crazy how my natural skin looks so light. Like, I used to always think I was one of those darker Asians, but with this type of foundation making me look really orange, I just couldn't tell if I liked it or not. And my under eye is really red too, so I guess it's a little bit of shock. So here I am buffing it out and seeing and ensuring that everything stays in place, that it doesn't move around. But wow, just a huge difference with the foundation to my natural skin. So I'm gonna fast forward this a little bit, but I wanted to add a touch of color to my brows. I then put on mascara, and then put on a lip SPF moisturizer, and then also used setting spray. I used the One Size by Patrick Star setting spray, the waterproof, just to see how long my foundation would last throughout the day. So I'm gonna do some running around, and I'll update you guys in regards to what the foundation looks like. Okay, so it's only been a couple of hours, like maybe two. I'm sitting in my car after I was just done shopping, but I feel like I look really orange. You can see these little marks from my glasses. And then you can still see like my natural skin tone and then just the way it looks. So when you come down to my neckline, it looks pretty natural, but just comparing my face right now to my hand and my neck skin, I don't know. I just look orange. The foundation itself, I do like. It's almost like skin-like. I'll have to pull up my camera so you can see like the crack of my nose, but I couldn't really get my nose with my sponge. What do you guys think? So it's been all day and I'm back again having you look at my face and all the imperfections that I see. I ended up going back to Ulta to go get the right color. As you can see through my progress, I should have timestamped it, but I didn't. Video editing has definitely been an experience for me trying to do it all myself, so I'm trying to quicken it up for you guys, but this video seems a little bit long. I'm going in and removing the Fenty side. I unfortunately went back to Ulta and I could not find or get the correct color for me for my Estee Lauder side, but I did speak to a consultant and she was very helpful, and our story was pretty funny on how she helped me picked my color. I'll have to tell you guys later. But there was no more there, so I just ended up getting the Fenty version and wanted to test it out to see what it would look like. So here you can see I'm shaking up my new bottle. So the new bottle that I got is going to be shade 260, so definitely a huge decrease in the number or color scheme. Shaking up the bottle and found a new sponge. I was gonna use an old sponge, but I decided to use a new sponge, and whoa, my first thought, this is way too light. I'm so used to wearing, as you can see, dark colors, but maybe that's my problem. And so when I dab this on, I'm like, holy moly, is this really my skin color? Because it's looking crazy light. I did 3 pumps in total, meant to do 2, but 3 came out, so I'm blending it away. Blend, blend, blend. Alright, so it's looking pretty good, and also matched my neck. So that's what I was looking out for, to see if it would go. I think my skin around my chin and my nose is really dry, and just to see now a super light color was pretty shocking too. And I'm seeing if it matched my neck, it matches my hand. I wanted it to set a little bit before I put powder on, so now I'm putting on some powder too to see what it would look like after everything. I think I'm still really shocked. I put my finger right there is because, as you can see, it actually blends really well with my natural skin between the 300 Fenty. So I think like the outcome. We'll have to test it out tomorrow for a full face. Thank you so much for watching this. Please like, subscribe, and comment on how I can be better in these videos. Thank you.